What lengths would you take to protect and defend your group? A. Get into a serious fistfight to defend your group's status. B. Pop your rivals' balloons or break their light sticks. C. Blackmail anti-fans and have them spread malicious posts against rival groups. D. Organize a Black Ocean in protest. E. Move on with your life and just enjoy the music in your group. Hi everyone, and welcome back to Midnight Theories, and if you're new here, welcome to Midnight Theories. These days, K-pop is known not only for its music, but also for its strong and massive community. Although at the end of the day, we are one big community, there have been many power struggles within the fandom that at times created chaos debating who is the most successful or talented in the industry. So what is a fandom exactly? In K-pop, it is a group or community of people who support or are devoted to a specific group or artist. In K-pop, most artists have a color or fandom name to represent their fans. Beyond the name and color, first-generation fans had balloons in their respective color that they would wave around at concerts and events, which later evolved into light sticks we know today. Fan wars have been around since the very beginning of K-pop. Back then, older fans said that K-pop fandoms between the first and second generation closely resembled mafia or gangs due to the brutal lengths they would go for their idol. They'd often travel in big packs asserting their dominance on smaller fandoms by carrying wooden paddles, popping each other's balloons, and engaging in fistfights over any disagreement. It was dangerous back then to claim a fandom in fear of your safety from rivals. Specifically, boy group stans would brag about their power due to their large numbers and claim their territory at concerts where rival groups would be in attendance. Here are just a few fan wars that almost tore the community apart with their intense battles on and offline. The most infamous and vicious fan war known in the community was between the fandoms of H.O.T. and Zetskis. These two fandoms were known to get into hardcore physical fights with each other at any chance they could get. One specific incident was the legendary Rain Fight. H.O.T. and Zetskis were both set to perform at a music show on the same day. H.O.T.'s White Angels and Zetskis' Yellow Keys sat across each other in the pouring rain, waiting to get into the broadcasting station. A few words were exchanged and quickly escalated into a brawl. This was so well known that it was even recreated in the K-drama Reply 1997.
캔디 한 곡으로 언제까지 울고 먹으실 거예요? 지금까지 헤쳐드셨으면 됐잖아요.
이년이 진짜
이런.
Yes! Tony from H.O.T. recalled witnessing a similar incident in the past. He was asked by an interviewer why he didn't stop the fight. He said, "How could I stop it? I was busy running away to safety myself." J-Duck added, "A fan ran up to me and yelled, 'Oppa, I won against three H.O.T. fans. Now that I look back on it, I think she was bleeding.' I patted her on the back and told her good job. Now I would tell them not to do that, but at the time I was proud of them." In a separate interview, the members of Zetskis were asked if they ever saw any of the rumored fights in person. They claimed they never witnessed anything firsthand, but they did hear about the rumors. Sunghoon was asked about a rumor of an H.O.T. fan spitting in his face and asked if it was true. He revealed,
뭐 그냥 그 자리를 떴다는 그런 소문이 그때 있었어. 근데 진짜야 뭐야 그게?
저는 그 친구의 얼굴을 아직도 기억을 하고 있어요. 너무 생생해서. 퇴근해서 이제 침을 뱉는 거죠. 근데
If you want to see a glimpse of how it was like to be a fan in the 90s, you should watch Reply 1997. Boygroup stans weren't the only ones partaking in this messy mix. The fandoms representing three of the biggest groups under the same label, SM Entertainment, entered into a disastrous family feud. TVXQ and Super Junior were two of the hottest boy bands leading K-pop during the second generation of idols. Their label mate, Girls' Generation, was also skyrocketing to stardom, competing with big name boy groups on their own, which some saw as a threat and stirred up jealousy between some boy group stans. In the early 2000s, Girls' Generation fandom Soans, Super Junior's fandom Elves, and TVXQ's fandom Cassiopeia got themselves into a heated fan war so far back that no one can really remember when it first started. One of the first accounts netizens can remember, an SNSD member Taeyeon performed a comedy skit with Super Junior's Kangin. Taeyeon was accused of being rude to him on a radio show during the skit, even though she was following her script and had no bad intent. A second incident was when Tiffany imitated a member of Shinhwa. These performances did not sit well with Elves, and intense rumors manifested as a result. In the year 2008, the infamous Black Ocean at the 2008 Dream Concert occurred. For those of you who don't know what a Black Ocean is, also known as a 10-minute, during a large-scale event where multiple groups perform, such as the Dream Concert, multiple fandoms are in attendance and wave around their light sticks to show their support at their groups and others. Anti-fans will turn off their light sticks to protest, and in some occasions, they will turn their backs to the stage and yell out other groups' names to cover fan chants. No one is certain who organized this Black Ocean, but Elves were given the blame for it, even though several other boy group fandoms were in agreement to participate. At the Dream Concert, where the stadium was twinkling, a rainbow-like show of light sticks from all fandoms all night soon switched to a dark, absent crowd as soon as Girls' Generation stepped on stage. The only light of support you could see on stage were the dainty pink lights of Soan's. To make matters worse, the crowd began yelling Wonder Girls, a strong competitor of Girls' Generation, during their performance, and also made X's with their arms and light sticks. Because this was a huge event, Mnet made an entire documentary of the Black Ocean. Before the concert started, other fandoms were already preparing to boycott the girl group. One fan was interviewed and stated that Soans were picking fights online, they pledged that they would stay silent the entire performance and turn off their light sticks. But oh no, the battle was just beginning. The heated arguments and debates would continue past the Dream Concert. Amongst balloons, light sticks, and signs to symbolize one's fan pride, fans would sometimes wave flags. There was one incident during the Dream Concert where Super Junior's and TVXQ's flags were unfortunately torn. After the concert, two rumors circulated around the community about the torn flags. A number of SNSD boys ran towards Super Junior's banner and ripped them apart right in front of Elves. The second says that Soans tore the banners because Elves and the other boy group fandoms organized the Black Ocean in the first place. At the time, no one was for certain who exactly ripped it, but apparently it was cleared up that it was the stadium staff that tore the banners because they were too big. But at the time, the fans were furious and the flags were torn and catapulted the insidious attacks against each other. Rumors spawned against Soans that they were carrying knives and deemed a dangerous fandom, only for it to escalate that they were now stabbing members of other fandoms, breaking their legs, and assaulting them during the concert. Photos of the alleged attacks were also uploaded to stir up drama. The documentary tackled any leads and found them all to be false. Years later, SNSD were asked about the Black Ocean, and the members said that they were pretty much unaware of the situation at the time. Back then, while we were promoting our first album, Into the New World, at the Dream Concert, there was a 10-minute boycott. We started on the stage to a dark, silent audience, like no one was even there. We were focused on the stage, so we didn't really know about the boycott. There was only one little pink light amidst all the darkness. This would not be Soan's last time in the battlefield defending their group. Girls' Generation and 21 wielded the title of two of the most influential and chart-topping girl groups to take over the K-pop scene between the years of 2007 to 2017. Due to their mega success, their fandom Soans and Blackjacks entered into an intense back and forth online, not only debating who is the most successful girl group, but viciously dragging the members' appearances and talent. The peak of this fan war is best documented during the year 2014. Girls' Generation had just released Mr. Mister, and 21 released Come Back Home soon after. Due to both groups competing for the number one spot on Inkigayo, each fandom released Hellfire on each other and campaigned their respective group's title track. This was all anyone could talk about. There was even a theory that YG purposely delayed 21's comeback just so that they could compete with Girls' Generation. For some backstory, YG did postpone the album that included the single Come Back Home for 2 days, but the reason they gave was it to be released on 21 later CL's birthday. The day finally came where 21, Girls' Generation, and 4MINUTE entered a showdown for first place. Both sides were convinced that their group would win, but in an unexpected twist, 4MINUTE ended up winning the big prize. Just because neither group won the battle, the war between Soans and Blackjacks was still not over. The fans continued the feud at the end of the year award shows, where two were nominated for Best Female Group and Artist of the Year. The second turn of events, neither group won again. EXO took the win for Artist of the Year, and SISTAR won Best Female Group. Years would pass and the war would die down. However, once again, this would not conclude the fan war between the two. In June of 2020, real-time hashtags, hashtag Stream21ComeBackHome, and Stream SNSD Mr. Mister began trending on Twitter to everyone's surprise. The hashtags were a product of a screenshot from Facebook, discussing which group's MV would reach 90 million views first. At the beginning of the stream race, 21 was in the lead with 88 million, while Girls' Generation fell behind at 87.5. Currently, both MVs are now on the road to 100 million. The fun war resulted in a friendly stream war and birthed some funny memes in the process, showing not all fan wars remain toxic. The Dream Concert seemed to be a battlefield for a lot of fandoms. In the early 2000s, Ihyori, a member of Finkel at the time, and TVXQ were a part of the 2004 Dream Concert lineup. The rivalry between the two fandoms started over a balloon color. To a fandom, the importance of a symbolic color is to distinguish yourself and your community from others and proudly represent your group. It also helps the artists on stage to find where their fandom is located in the stands. Binkle's group color was red/pearl red, while rookie group TVXQ were still not set on an official color, but fans were using the color pearl red. In 2003 and 2004, Finkel was on a hiatus while the members did solo activities, so Cassiopeia's TVXQ's fandom told Pinky's Finkel's fandom that the color would be used temporarily. Back then, there were not many balloon colors to choose from. Pinkies were not too happy about this and immediately asked the other fandom to change their color. But as TVXQ's popularity skyrocketed, the color pearl red became a staple for the group. Pinkies were not happy about this because the color was too close in resemblance to theirs. So at the Dream Concert, Pinkies devised a plan to warn TVXQ fandom from continuing to use the color. Thus, the Great Balloon War took place. On the day of the concert, Pinkies collected all the pearl red balloons and hid them in the stairway. Because the fan war became too intense, news got to the members of the actual group and they had to release a statement to make the fans stop fighting. Personally, there are quite a few people who ask about the perfume I use. As long as I don't take away all the perfume in the world, it can be anyone's perfume. As it blends with the person's own body odor, the same perfume has a different feeling. A red balloon can be anyone's. I think it's about who is waving at whom, not the sole ownership of a red balloon. For the four of us, the fans who wave the red balloons are happy and thankful. Funny enough, in 2015, when Icon made their debut, rumors that their fan color would also be red made TVXQ's fandom furious for it being too close to theirs and demanded YG Entertainment change their color. This brought up the balloon fan war by the other fandoms, reminding TVXQ's fandom that they originally, quote, stole the color first. Icon's color stayed a shade of red, with their official color being orange-red. However, this is not the only time fandoms have fought over a shade of color. There's only so many colors you can choose from before they overlap with the oversaturation of groups. It's inevitable that it will happen from time to time. The end-of-the-year award shows and festivals are held to celebrate artists and award their accomplishments. These events typically unite groups for special performances. At the 2011 SBS Music Festival, popular rookie groups B1A4 and Dal Shabit shared the stage for a fun collaboration. This leads to the forgotten extreme fan war between the fandoms of B1A4's Banas and Dal Shabit's fandom Darlings. During the 2-minute performance, there's a quick, and I mean super quick part of the choreography where B1A4 greases their hands on the members of Dal Shabit's legs and Dal Shabit body rolls against the members of B1A4. It took less than 5 seconds to create chaos on both sides of the fandom. After the performance, malicious comments flooded the forums and blogs attacking Dal Shabit. One of the rumors circulating online was specifically targeting Seti. A user online claimed that they asked Seti for an autograph and handshake, which the idol rejected. These comments took a toll on Seti, and she went online to address the slanderous comments and name-dropped a specific fandom impulsively. Seti's desperate plea to Banas added more fuel to the fire and caused a disastrous chain of events. Banas were riled up online, and Seti was forced to do some damage control by writing an apology letter. This made the situation die down for the time being, but just a week away, a popular event where idol groups gathered together was just around the corner. It's the beginning of 2020, at the time of the Idol Star Athletic Championship, also known as ISAC for short. Rumors spawned that Dal Shabit Seti and the group's fan would be thrown raw eggs if anyone spotted her in public. Banas took it one step forward and claimed that Darlings were assaulting, kidnapping, and raping Banas. The situation got so out of hand that the police had to intervene. Police officials revealed there weren't any disturbances or crimes committed during the Idol Star Athletic Championship. There was nothing out of the ordinary that occurred, nor were there any reports of such behavior. Happy Face Entertainment also released a statement about the rumors, imploring netizens to stop the harassment of their idols. Seti went back online to express her feelings on the situation. Shortly after the chaos, on January 10, 2012, a separate incident occurred where Dal Shabit's official site was hacked. Fans who visited Dal Shabit's homepage were met with several pop-ups that prevented them from entering the site. The pop-ups had a picture of B1A4 with the message, "Why are you messing with us, Banas?" B1A4 fans had also put up several notices and posts about B1A4 in other sections of Dal Shabit's homepage. Dal Shabit and B1A4 agreed to not let these rumors affect themselves or the relationship. And the fan war died down after that. An even darker turn of fan wars online was the 2021 secret chat room that was exposed after the Reign of Terror. The K-pop community, and especially Once's, Twice's fandom, was in the middle of mass hysteria when reports of an alleged chat room run by a user under the alias American Guy used his chat room called the Slave Room to spread malicious rumors against rival groups. Allegedly, American Guy was a fan of a rival group of Twice. The purpose of these chat rooms was so he could take revenge on anti-fans of his favorite group and fearlessly claim that he created a system that enslaved these haters. The user reportedly would find these hate comments under his favorite group's videos or posts and would blackmail these individuals into joining the slave room. The members in this chat room, some being minors as young as elementary school age, were monitored 24/7 and forced to write malicious comments under groups American Guy didn't like and leave positive comments under the groups American Guy did like. There were also smaller chat rooms American Guy would monitor, divided into 10 to 12 members per room, and reports claimed that there was a total of 80 members in the group. The members' jobs were to monitor American Guy's favorite groups and look for haters or anti-fans. If these members proved themselves to do enough, then they would be promoted or freed. American Guy took credit for multiple rumors and scandals against Twice. Not just Twice were the victims of these alleged attacks. Groups such as Mamamoo, Oh My Girl, Promise 9, and all the active groups under JYP's label were also targeted. Once the K-pop community found out about American Guy's mission to tear down these groups, the community band together to try to stop this user from hurting any more groups. These days, fan wars, if any, typically get handled online, where instead of fearing anything physical, it's handled with doxing and cancel culture. Do you think some of these past fan wars were just as bad or worse than the ones happening today? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. And as always, thank you for watching and enjoy your stay.